In part one, AI analyzed our leads and told us how we were doing within our sales pipeline. But for this video, we're focusing on part two, where we're gonna dive into the numbers of it all, the finance, when a payment comes in, how do we record that? How do we tie it back to the sales rep who deserves credit? And how do we calculate the commission? I'm gonna break it all down for you step by step in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of Airtable and the related tools in and around the no-code space. Now, as I said in the beginning here, we are focused on the second part of our sales CRM. This is using, well, real-ish data. I've obviously had to make some adjustments so that you don't see the names and personal information of people that we're speaking with, but we're going to track our new sales rep, Zion, and kind of walk through how his first month, his first 30 days here at Gap went, and I'll show you exactly how we're tracking commissions and everything else along with it. Now, before I jump into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join us for some free training. I've put together an Airtable crash course that teaches the basics of Airtable so that you can fully unlock the true power of this tool. If you want to learn about all those key features, sign up for free at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen here and we're going to pick up where we left off in part one. So, we had already shared about our inquiry calls pipeline. We've created opportunities from the inquiry calls. And so these different opportunities are being tracked through the process here, and we can move them from the initial inquiry was held to we followed up, to we followed up again, and ultimately, if they get placed in negotiation because there's some back and forth and they're interested in moving forward, then fantastic. We want to move them here. But of course, if they're not interested in continuing on forward, we're going to mark those leads as lost. They didn't want to go forward with us, or they ignored our emails, or whatever the case may be. And then, best case scenario, they move into the closed one. So all of this is tracked by the sales rep. And here we've been able to build this inquiry pipeline that is actually kind of like a Kanban, but it uses Airtable's new roadmap, which means we can break it down into the grouped rows to see what opportunity type they are. Are they a project, custom development, or are they looking for hourly support and just maybe some ad hoc work? Which of those two buckets do they fill in? But then also, across the columns here, what is the status? Just an initial inquiry, or have we followed up? Are we in negotiation? And ultimately, either won or lost. And so as we already looked at, we have the ability to track all of the different information here. We have the transcript files. We see how the history of this has gone on. And we know the history of this person as they've interacted with our team. But now we've got to dive into the financials. So where does that all come into play? Well, we're going to start with the back end here. We have a table for transactions, and the transaction record in its simplest form is just going to record the payment transaction ID from Stripe, the receipt URL, so we can actually click on any one of these things to see what it is that person bought. This receipt is also shared directly with the client when they make the purchase, so they have that for their records. We see the status that came from Stripe, when it was created, and also when it was paid, just in case there's a disconnect between these two dates. We can see when it was due, if it was an invoice. And of course, we can link it, and this is important, link it to the client. Now, the linking part is critical because we need to calculate commissions for the various sales reps. And so the sales rep is known based on the opportunity. The sales rep created the opportunity, which is linked to the client, and then provided that the sales rep created the opportunity, and we know that the client, when they pay, we know who they are, we can then track who the sales rep is who deserves the credit for closing the sale, and therefore make sure that we pay commissions appropriately. So we are tracking, obviously, the total amount as well, and the payment method. Now, all of this is coming, obviously, through automation. And so we've used Zapier for this. It's a fairly simple automation that is recording that a new payment was made in Stripe. Easy enough, right? Then what happens? We find or create this person in Airtable. if the customer already exists inside of our people table in Airtable, we don't want to create a new record for them. So we're using the find slash create function, which basically within Zapier says, I'm going to search based on the rules that you establish. And here we've established the rule that we're looking for the email. If a record already exists in Airtable with this email that we got from the transaction in Stripe, then we're going to take that record. And that's the one that we're moving forward with. But if they don't already exist, then we need to create a new person record inside of Airtable. And we're going to create that record, marking them as a client, making sure we fill out the information that came from Stripe, and ultimately creating that new record so that we can use it in the next step. Because as I mentioned, the next step is the transaction. So this is important because it links to the person who made the payment. So as you can see, in every case, we're going to create that transaction record in our transactions table. And here we can bring in other information like the receipt URL that I showed you earlier, the success of the payment, when it was created, who the client is. So we are linking to the client that we found or created in the previous step. We're bringing in the total amount, etc. All of this information is then added automatically to our transactions table. So how does that then get interpreted by the sales team? That all comes down to the accounting interface. So here we have an interface that, for starters, is looking at all the transactions that were received. And so again, this is filtered down specifically for Zion, our newest sales rep, and he can come in and filter in and look at particular clients. He can filter in particular products or when the actual payment was made. But just in the last 30 days, you can see that Zion has already started closing deals and he's made already $16,000 in sales, which is fantastic. In the interface, we've built the following elements. So the first one is so that he can see over time how he's doing, bucketed by week. And so obviously, as things ramp up for Zion, he's going to see more and more sales. And you can see that just last week, he broke the $10,000 a week mark for the first time. So he's making fantastic progress. And frankly, I couldn't be happier with the way that the system is coming together. But then scrolling down here, we can actually see the breakdown of those transactions. What actually was purchased? What was the amount? Who is it that made the purchase? All of that information is tied in right here. And of course, we also enable Zion to be able to click in so that he can actually see this information at a higher level. Now, you might also notice that we're using another AI agent here because I've built into it an agent to say, to automatically categorize these purchases, to say based on the amount, what do you think this purchase actually is? So we've built specific packages, and most of the time our purchases fall within those packages, but sometimes the agent might be confused, and so it does something like says unknown. So we have a lot of different things that we've sold over the years and different ways that we've packaged our services, but the agent knows all of that and it automatically categorizes for us. But the next layer is understanding commissions. So let's dial in on those transactions and scroll all the way over to the right to find out how the commissions come together. So the first part of this is the commission percent. Here I've got a formula set up for the way we track our commissions, and right now everything is a flat 5%, but using this type of a field enables us to change that commission over time if we need to revisit the commission percentages within our sales team. And the next component is that commission calculation. So it's taking the total amount of the transaction and applying the commission percentage to it to calculate the amount that we have to pay to the sales rep. But the most important part is knowing who the sales rep is. And that is, as I alluded to earlier, discovered through the client-linked relationship. So based on who made the purchase, and that was all tracked in the automation that we outlined, based on the client, whoever the sales rep is that was working with that client is the person who should get the commission. And so we're able to bring that in. And in this case, I filtered it down just to show us Zion and the commissions that he has earned in the first month of being here. So all of this is then brought into our interface. So we have open commissions here. And again, we can filter down at the top, But you can look at the total transaction count, the total amount in sales, and then ultimately the total due in commissions over that period of time. Now, when this first full month with Zion has wrapped up, we're going to move into the paid commissions as well. And so back on the data layer, if you might scroll over to the far right, you'll see that we have the payment status that we track here of whether it's an unpaid or a paid commission. And then ultimately, we mark the date that it was paid. So we can effectively just mark these things as paid, which then can trigger an automation to mark the date that it was paid. And that will then be filtered into the next component for Zion, where he can track the commissions that he has received. So he can track the actual revenue at every stage in the game. He can see what his open commissions are, and then lastly, what his paid commissions are. So he can go back and see all of this information. Now, we're a very transparent organization, and we run a lean team, so we want it to be this way. But you could, of course, lock down more of this information if you were building something that perhaps wasn't as transparent. And whatever permissions you're giving to your team, they can only see what you give them access to. Now, one last thing I want to call out here is that AI in Airtable is so incredibly powerful that we can do so much more with it, and we've only started to scratch the surface. One thing I want to call out is being able to communicate with Omni directly within the interfaces. And the best part about this is, depending on who is interacting with Omni, whatever their ability is to see information in Airtable and in the interfaces, well, Omni will only respond to them having analyzed that data. So if somebody asks a question and maybe they don't have access to other people's commissions, well, then Omni is unable to answer that appropriately for them. And this is exactly what you want. People being able to query Omni or AI directly within your app. So here, for example, Zion could go back to maybe his pipeline and he could ask Omni to analyze the meeting transcripts that he's had over the last 30 days to tell him where he could improve on his sales calls to get a better percentage to close. So these are the types of ways that you can truly leverage AI, and the go-getters within your organization can become even more powerful, even better at their jobs, because you're enabling them with better data. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. Of course, if you have questions that we didn't answer, swing by our website because we've put together a ton of resources, and you might even consider scheduling your own strategy call with our team. And if you're lucky, you might even get Zion. Of course, we'd also love it if you could subscribe to the channel and thumbs up on the video if you want to see more content like this. But the most important thing, as always, keep on building.